morning. It's Friday, July 24th, 2020. I'm Russell, and this is Rocky Road Devotions, a few minutes of help for today's journey. Our devotion today is entitled, The Surrendered Life, and our scripture is Psalm 119. Your laws are wonderful. No wonder I obey them. The teaching of your word gives light, so even the simple can understand. I pant with expectation, longing for your commands. Come and show me your mercy, as you do for all who love your name. Guide my steps by your word, so I will not be overcome by evil. As Prime Minister of Great Britain, Winston Churchill was an inspiring leader through the nightmare of World War II. In a speech to his alma mater, he advised the students to neither give up or give in. With apologies to Mr. Churchill's memory, that's precisely what we were all created to do, surrender. Admittedly, Mr. Churchill was rightly advising the graduates to persevere through difficulties, such as the temptation to give in to something dishonorable or the threat of an unconscionable monster like Adolf Hitler. The kind of surrender to which our psalm writer advocates is our human will and its allegiance to God's will. The psalmist, probably King David, had learned the importance of living the surrendered life by faith, and also by the unfortunate experience of not standing by his faith. David had given in to temptation, sinned greatly against God, and because he surrendered to God's sovereignty, he had been forgiven and restored by God's grace. About this whole business of our stubborn will and how the surrender of it to God avails us of the solution to eternity's biggest fear and penalty is one of the most perplexing of human mysteries. This conundrum of human bent towards self-destruction is, at once, a universal flaw in our souls and a startling field of self-discovery. When we realize how lost we are without God, the light bulb switches on, and we then have the choice of doors to walk through to our solution. Some choose the door of surrender, the rest choose death. In some small way, I understand my own heart as to why we participate in the foolishness of resisting God's grace. As a young teen, I sensed God's sovereignty and how I was accountable for my actions. I ran from that sense of culpability just as Adam and Eve tried to hide their sins behind fig leaves. What is so absurd about that is how, having heard many sermons and personally read the scriptures that show God to be merciful and forgiving, I still wanted independence. My will was my will, and even a benevolent, forgiving, gracious God wasn't going to have that. I was the proverbial two-year-old holding my toy, tight-fisted, independent, self-centered. Aren't we all? In my case, the teenage rebellion ran its course before I turned 30, and that independence lost a good bit of luster under the load of emptiness I'd amassed in my soul. It finally became clear that surrender to God's offer of forgiveness was the only hope left for one of God's creatures who had gotten himself horribly out of the place where God's image had once been. It was an empty place Russell had tried to fill with a career and family and experiences and stuff. None of that could take the place of a God that can fill your heart with love, joy, peace, gentleness, kindness, and every other kind of good, fulfilling, life-giving hope. So I surrendered, and God was good to his promise. He still is. Let's pray together. Father, many of us have had that same experience, trying to hold you at arm's length just because our pride makes us stubborn. For those who have joined you in total surrender, they know your kindness and the joy of a heart filled with light and purpose. For those who still resist, may the emptiness drive them to the only home they were created for, your arms. For you today, if you've discovered the surrendered life, you know the joy. If you haven't, give us a call. Let's talk about it. There's good stuff waiting for you on the other side of the Amen. You chew on that as you hit the rocky road. Have a blessed day.